Hello everyone, welcome back. My name is Rajni Chaudhary and in this particular video, we will be discussing about the arc phenomena in the circuit breaker. Following will be the content of this video. Here, we will start with the review of circuit breaker. A video about the circuit breaker, the basics of circuit breaker is already given. You can go through that video. The link is given in the description box below. But still, we will be reviewing some of the circuit breaker concepts here. Then we will discuss the arc phenomena, which occurs during the separation of the two contacts of the circuit breaker, the various terminologies related to the arc phenomena, and then we will be discussing the methods of arc extraction and the theories related to the concept of arc extraction, followed by the references of the video. Before starting the video, let's have a quick review of the circuit breaker. As discussed, a circuit breaker is an electromechanical device which can either make or break the connection. Under the normal operating condition, we can make or break a circuit either manually or by the remote control. But during a fault condition, the circuit is broken automatically. Thus, a circuit breaker consists of fixed and moving contacts, which are called electrodes. These contacts are intact with each other during the normal operation, but we can separate the two contacts either manually or by the remote control as discussed above. But when a fault occurs, the moving contact has a trip coil attached with it and the trip coil gets energized and therefore the moving contact is pulled away from the fixed contact. Therefore, the two contacts, fixed contact and the moving contact, are separated from each other and the connection between them is broken. Therefore, the faulty current is interrupted from flowing into the circuit. Arc phenomena. So, till now we have studied that when a fault occurs, the two contacts of the circuit breaker get separated from each other, and that's how the faulty current is interrupted from flowing into the system. But it's not that simple, as when the two contacts of the circuit breaker are separated or are open, the medium between the two contacts get highly ionized. Now, how this happens? When the two contacts are separated, the contact area between them decreases, which leads to increased current density and rise in temperature. This rise in temperature produces large amount of heat, and therefore the low resistive part between the two contacts becomes so heated that it appears in the form of an arc. So the current is not interrupted here only. The current continues to flow into the system with the help of the arc so formed. As the potential difference between the two contacts is quite small, and therefore it maintains the arc. Also, during the arcing period, the current flowing between the contacts depend upon the arc resistance. If the arc resistance is greater, then the smaller amount of current will be flowing between the contacts. So, for the total interruption of the current, it is mandatory that this arc so developed needs to be quenched as quickly as possible. Now, as we have discussed, there is an arc formation. But how this arc formation takes place? We know that there are always some free electrons and ions present in air or the gas, but they are insufficient to conduct the electricity. They can conduct electricity only if the temperature increases, which is called the thermal ionization of the gas. And this temperature increases because the current density increases as a result of the contact area being decreased when the two contacts are separated from each other. Also, the free electrons are able to conduct electricity in presence of strong electric field, which is known as ionization due to electrical field. So, there are some important terms which are very much related to the arc phenomena and therefore need to be studied. These are, first, arc voltage. Arc voltage is defined as the voltage that appears across the contacts of the circuit breaker during the arcing period. We know that when a fault appears, then the contacts of the circuit breakers are separated and arc is formed between them. The voltage that appears across the contacts of the circuit breaker during this arcing period is known as arc voltage. Second one, restriking voltage. It is defined as the transient voltage that appears across the contacts of the circuit breaker at or near current zero during the arcing period. This is caused by the rapid distribution of energy between the magnetic and electric field associated with the plant and transmission line of the system. Therefore, at current zero situation, a high frequency transient voltage appears, and this transient voltage is known as restriking voltage. As you can see in the diagram, these spikes are termed as the restriking voltage. This is basically the transient voltage which is occurring during the arcing period. The third one, that is the recovery voltage. The recovery voltage, as you can see in the figure, the dotted line represents the recovery voltage. It is the normal frequency RMS voltage that appears across the contacts of the circuit breaker after the final arc extension. It is generally approximately equal to your system voltage, and therefore you can see that the dotted lines are basically your system voltage. Methods of arc interruption. There are two methods by which the arc can be interrupted. First, high resistance method. Second, low resistance method. This low resistance method is also known as zero current interruption method. In high resistance method, the value of arc resistance is increased with time so that the current reaches to a value that it is not sufficient enough to maintain the arc. Now, how can we increase the arc resistance? Since we know that the resistance value R is equal to rho L by A. So, if we are going to increase the value of length, then automatically we are going to increase the value of resistance. The first method for increasing the arc resistance is by lengthening the arc. Here, we increase the length of the arc so that the resistance, the arc resistance, get increased. The second method is cooling the arc. Cooling will help in deionization of the medium between the contacts, and therefore it will increase the resistance value. Third method is by decreasing the cross section of the arc. We know that the resistance is inversely proportional to cross section of the arc. So if we are going to reduce the value of cross section, then automatically the resistance value will increase. The fourth method for increasing the arc resistance is by splitting the arc. The resistance of the arc here is increased by splitting the arc into number of small arcs in series, and hence the effect of lengthening and cooling applied to these small arc will be more effective as compared to one single arc. The high resistance method is generally employed only in DC circuit breakers and low capacity AC circuit breakers, because large enormous energy is dissipated in the form of arc. So it is not suitable for employing the high resistance method in case of high capacity AC circuit breakers. Talking about the low resistance method or the zero interruption method, this is generally applied for AC circuits only. Here, we know that in an AC system,
the current drops to zero after every half cycle, and therefore the name is given zero current interruption method. In an AC system, when the current drops to the zero value, the arc extinguishes for a brief moment because it reaches a value of zero. Now, if in that moment we are going to increase the dielectric strength of the medium, then the restriking voltage value will be not achieved. Hence, the dielectric strength of the medium between the contact is built up more rapidly than the voltage across the contacts in this method. Here, by building the dielectric strength of the medium more as compared to the voltage across the contacts, the arc will fail to restrike and therefore the current can be interrupted.
Theories of arc interruption. So, as discussed in the following two methods, that is the high resistance method and the low resistance method, we can say that there are two basic theories by which we can explain how the arc can be extinguished. These are the energy balance theory and second, the voltage race theory. These two theories explain how we can extinguish the arc. Energy balance theory. According to this theory, the arc can be extinguished if the rate of the generation of the heat between the contacts of the circuit breaker is lower than the rate at which the heat between the contact is dissipated. That is, the rate of generation of heat must be lower or must be lesser than the rate of dissipation of heat. Now, how can we achieve this? We can increase the dissipation heat rate by lengthening the arc, cooling the arc, and splitting the arc into several pieces. By doing so, we can achieve the dissipation rate voltage race theory. According to this theory, the arc can be extinguished if the rate of the rise of the restriking voltage is lesser than the rate at which the dielectric strength of the medium increases. But how can we achieve this? How can we increase the rate at which the dielectric strength of the medium increases greater than the rate of the rise of restriking voltage? This is done by causing the ionized particle to recombine into neutral molecules. In this way, there will be less number of ionized particles between the two contacts of the circuit breaker. Also, by removing the ionized particles and replacing them with the unionized particles, we can increase the dielectric strength. These are some of the references from where the content of the slide has been prepared. With this, we end here only. In this video lecture, we have studied how the arc formation takes place in circuit breaker when the two contacts are separated and how we can extinguish the arc. For more videos, stay connected and thank you.